This is News Nation Now.
Good morning. Welcome to News Nation Now. I'm Jisoo Kyi. It's Wednesday, March 31st. Here's your update. Breaking news. Middle school children may get the most benefit of anyone from the Pfizer COVID vaccine. The company's CEO says he'll submit phase three clinical test results that show the vaccine to be 100% effective on kids ages 12 to 15. And listen to this. Not a single child who got the vaccine got an infection. Pfizer plans to push federal regulators to get younger people vaccinated in time for the fall semester. Also new overnight, the suspect in the attack of a 65-year-old Asian woman in New York has been arrested. Brandon Elliott, 38, of New York City, is charged with felony assault as a hate crime. The New York Police Department says the victim was walking to church in Midtown Manhattan when Elliott approached her, yelling racial slurs and kicking her repeatedly, even after she fell to the ground. Nearby employees in a lobby entrance who witnessed the incident but didn't intervene have been suspended. The woman is hospitalized with serious injuries. It's the second attack on an Asian person in New York this week. Happening today, President Joe Biden will unveil the first phase of his infrastructure package during a speech in Pittsburgh. It would unleash $2 trillion in new spending in four areas: transportation, public water, health and broadband systems, community care for seniors, and innovation research and development. It would be paid for by permanently raising the corporate tax rate from 21% to 28%. Also, we're watching today, the Supreme Court will hear arguments in a case about how colleges can reward athletes who play Division I basketball and football. Under current NCAA rules, students can't be paid, and the scholarship money colleges can offer is capped at the cost of attending school. Also, the trial of former police officer Derek Chauvin continues today with more testimony from witnesses. A Minneapolis firefighter who voiced frustration at being prevented from using her EMT training to help George Floyd will be back on the stand. For the first time, journalists have been allowed inside one of the main border detention facilities housing migrant children. Video from inside the facility in Donna, Texas, revealed overcrowded tent structures, sleeping mats on the floor, and children being processed. The facility is intended to hold 250 people. Now, more than 4,000 children and families fill the space. President Biden has declined to resume the Trump-era practice of expelling unaccompanied immigrant children, sparking criticism from Republicans. Watch News Nation correspondent Marky Martin's full story on NewsNationNow.com. A timeline has now been given for the deposit of delayed stimulus check payments. White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki said the IRS is on track to send those payments out this weekend, and the majority of people should see them in their bank accounts on Wednesday, April 7th. Find out more on NewsNationNow.com. And trending this morning, Google Maps will soon guide you through indoor malls, airports, and even more. The company yesterday announced several new features, including one that allows you to use augmented reality to find your way indoors at large public places. And the arrows will guide you. The rollout is expected in major cities in coming months. Something I could definitely use. Thanks so much for watching. Stay with us throughout the day for breaking news coverage here on our app and website. And News Nation's broadcasts start tonight at 5 Central with Early Edition with Nicole Burley. Have a great Wednesday, everybody.